Meanwhile, Meghan's father, believe it or not, could be set to give evidence against her in court. This is the case, of course, that Meghan and Harry brought against a newspaper for publishing the contents of letters between Meghan and her dad. Well, join me now is royal correspondent Roya Nikkhah. And you know what? Here he is. We thought we sorted this, or the Queen did. Drawn a line under it. Let's move on. She's not very happy, but let's move on. We'll all get on with it. And then this bombshell.
Yeah, I mean, today's papers are going to make just troubling reading for the Queen.
Yeah.
Because the thing that the royal family dreaded most was Markle versus Markle in court.
Yeah.
And the Mail on Sunday have come out and, you know, the court papers making a very, very strong defence. And it's absolutely clear they're willing to go all the way to court with this because they feel they have a very strong defence. Their argument being that Meghan Markle's expectation of privacy was slightly compromised because she effectively briefed various American publications, you know, possibly let that letter come out. So the notion that she could, you know, we could have her father giving evidence against her is going to absolutely horrify the royal family.
Couldn't it all have been prevented, though? This is the thing. I mean, I've been saying this for ages. The fact that he did some stupid things. He did some daft things. You know, he did those paparazzi shots and got paid for them. That was stupid. But everything else since, like, I don't believe he was paid to give the letter to the papers. I think he actually just gave it to them because he was feeling very bruised about the fact that she, you know, her friends had talked about it. It's just, it's crazy, isn't it? You just want, why did they not all just sit down and sort it? It's too late now, I think.
I think it is, you're definitely right. It's too late.
I
think there's a lot about that family situation that we don't know, that even close friends don't know.
Sure.
But that said, there's no doubt that, I mean, you know, certain royal aides before the wedding were very keen to try and handle this and go out and see Thomas Markle.
Right.
And that didn't happen. So read into that what you will.
Right.
I mean, I think also we've got to understand that, you know, Thomas Markle feels obviously very bruised. The Duchess of Sussex obviously feels bruised in her own way. I think just the fact that the family issue on her side of the family is coming to the fore again is, you know, potentially, who knows, that could be one of the reasons she decided to leave the UK now.
Perhaps. That's actually true. That's true. That apparently the royals are said to be feeling queasy about this.
I should think the Queen feels many, many things about this, and that's probably an understatement.
Yeah, and the consequences. I mean, it's all got very strange and quite surreal, hasn't it? Because we've got the situation now as well. You know, they're saying that they've got to earn their own keep, if you like. But we've got this mad situation where all this unauthorised merchandise is coming out. This is so bizarre, isn't it?
Well, I mean, you know, the story in the Times today about the merchandise is just the tip of the iceberg. I mean, it's a sort of slight tongue-in-cheek, you know, Megxit, cushions, all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
But it points to the much bigger, more complicated picture, which...
I mean, this is not them doing this, we should say. This is just people trying to make a fast buck, you know.
But this is like the public capitalising on it. The key thing now for the Queen and members of the Royal Family to try and sort out are exactly this. What commercial deals will or won't be allowed from Meghan and Harry? You know, they will get thousands of lucrative offers.
Oh, you can imagine.
But, you know, the royal family will think there are certain areas, you know, commercial deals that should be off the table because money and, you know, commercialising the royal HRH or the royal status is toxic for the royal family.
People have tried it before, though. Sarah Ferguson has done it, that's for sure. And other members of the royal family, minor members of the royal family, have cashed in, if you like. But we don't know the rules. There doesn't seem to be any rules. That's the thing.
I don't think even the Queen knows what those are going to be yet. I mean, that's what, you know, the Queen and private secretaries are trying to negotiate and trying to figure out. That's going to take a lot of time.
Yes.
The key, you know, one of the big problems is that Meghan and Harry just want to go very fast, I think, and they're moving things very quickly.
Sure.
And this is an institution that takes a lot of time to move. And we're talking about constitutional changes here.
Which is massive, isn't it? It's
huge.
Absolutely huge. What about the relationship between the two brothers? Because obviously they made that statement saying that William wasn't bullying Harry. That was too strong. People were too strong. But clearly there has been a divide here.
There absolutely has been, and I wrote about that at the weekend.
Indeed.
And made our front page. You know, I know that William is extremely sad about what's happened. He feels gutted that brotherly bond that was so close for so many years is broken. You know, I think too much blame has been put at Meghan's door for this. There were tensions between the brothers, you know, a while back before she arrived on the scene. And again, I wrote about that at the weekend.
Yes.
But there's no doubt that, you know, the dynamic in the family has changed catastrophically because, you know, they want to do things a different way. I think William feels very sad as well that I think Harry is behaving slightly differently towards his family and the Queen. Mm. And that's taken them by surprise. But, as you said, at the heart of it is a family.
Totally.
Feel very
family
sad.
Fallout. Yeah, and it's a family fallout. It really is. You just wonder if Meghan and Kate had got on a wee bit better, whether that would have helped. I don't know.
I'm not convinced. Would it have helped? Would it have avoided this? I don't think so. They're very, as anyone who watches them at work or as royal aides will tell you, they are very different characters.
Mm. Well, it's not going away, that's for sure. It really isn't. Thank you so much for your insight. I'm sure we'll be talking again. Thank you very much indeed.